So we're here in the Glicken House. Probably one of my favorite cockpits. I love the key and the start button up here. It's like a freaking fighter jet or something. Just needs a cage on it. Kind of like the reverse there. We got gear map, washer, wiper speed, light intensity, ABS mapping, brake bias there, some radio stuff, resets, looks like maybe traction control, more vents there, yeah, those are vents, all kinds of cool stuff, traction control on the wheel, nice clean display, and some nice digital mirrors right beside the steering wheel Motec there. So of course, the Glicken House runs in the SPX category.
All right, here we go.
Glicken House, very passionate about motorsport. They've actually expressed some interest in the ACO's hypercar regulations, wanting to run at Le Mans. Hopefully that comes through. That would be amazing. Very passionate team when it comes to motorsport. Just look at this thing, you can tell that I love racing. This is a race-built machine. It's really handy that those digital mirrors are there, because, man, you cannot see that mirror over there. This one, barely see anything. Nice and smooth. Is there. Flat out. Here we go, on to the Nordschleife. Nice and solid through there. Box, always exciting in a new car you've never driven. Just how much downforce will I get? Got the fleet plots here. A little bit of lift from the front end. Oh, buddy. It's a clenching moment. Oh, up over Schadenkreuz could use just a tiny bit more front downforce, I think. Down into the foxhole here. The forest. Danger zone here. That was tricky in an unfamiliar car. Metzgefeld. Thank you. the hill now. Triple right. Also tested the downforce and grip. Held it pretty well. I have to admit, I'm not 100% comfortable in this car. Can you ever be 100% comfortable at the Nordschleife? I don't know. Not if you're going fast. Love the audio through here. This thing is a joy. Berk here. Carry the speed up the hill. So when I'm recording this video, I am getting ready to travel to Europe. I'm going to be here at the Nürburgring for the 24 hours. Depending on when I release this video, I may already be here. So if you're at the circuit, come seek me out. Me and some Dutch guy. Up to the carousel here. I can handle it. Ran really nice through there. The Hawk. Sloppy there, but got away with it. Of course, N24, one of those sim races that still need to tick off the box. We tried it, but we were trying to do it as a two-man team, and yeah, kind of ruined it. Don't text and drive. Wrench in there. But this is such a demanding circuit. It's probably some of the most tired I've ever been during an endurance race. There's basically almost no rest on the lap. With it being so long, it's kind of nice. You don't feel like you've been going for a long time, but this, you know, it's so active, especially in traffic. You're constantly having to watch for cars. Just move and be actively involved in the driving, that it really wears you out. It's very hard to do a long stint. Huge respect for the VLN people who do a four-hour race solo. That's just, that's some epic stuff there. Into the straight, carry the speed. Don't text. That's number one rule here. Don't run into the tourist parking exit here. Under the Bilstein Bridge. Flat out in sixth here. Gear ratio is just about perfect. Up to the Tiergarten, I'm gonna chicken out a bit. Here we go. That was the Glickenhaus. What a treat this car is. I love, love, love this car. This thing is beautiful and excellent to drive. If you get a chance in Assetto Corsa, it comes with Assetto Corsa. Definitely check it out. Give it a go. Really, really fun car to drive. And it's beautiful. Look at this interior. I'm a sucker for a really good interior, as you know. Anyways, that's it for me, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. And I will see you guys at the Nürburgring. Bye for now.